We're speaking to one of New Zealand's most well-known authors. She's written more than 1,000 books with titles from the Mrs. Wishy-Washy series to Nickety-Nickety-Noo-Noo-Noo. Her words resemble fond memories for all generations of New Zealanders. Her lifelong passion for imagining thrilling and educational children's books earned her a spot on the shortlist for the Hans Christian Andersen Award in 2016, the highest international distinction for children's writers. In 2018, Cowley was made a member of the Order of New Zealand in the New Year's Honours List. And if that wasn't enough, she's still bringing joy to young Kiwis through her words as a patron for the Featherston Book Festival. And she joins us now to talk about her latest collection, the Gobbledygook Book. Joy, bringing joy. How fitting. Thank you so much for being with us.
Oh, thank you. There are times in my life when I have not liked my name.
Oh.
But I do like it when I'm with people like you.
It is lovely.
Thank you.
It is lovely. Now, I mean, saying that you've written over 1,000 books.
And that's over a long life, of course, of writing. I love my job. The focus has been writing books that children will enjoy when they're learning to read. That's very important, that the reading, learning to read is pleasurable. And it wasn't for me when I was a child. So
what was it like for you when you were a child?
Oh, it was an old phonics system that came out from England. And it was wartime, an overcrowded classroom. And it was punctuated by raps around the leg with a ruler.
Oh.
So
that doesn't sound fun at
all. I saw myself as a bad reader. And I was about 9 before I broke through into reading, and it was a book that did it. A picture book called Ping, the Little Duckling. And that book made me realise the beauty of story.
And is that what inspired you to write your own?
Yeah. So reading, learning to read, must be a life-giving, enjoyable task. Not a matter of putting bits of language together that have no meaning.
In this day and age, of course, people have got devices and they're all on their computers and they're on the internet and they're in chat rooms and social media. Are you worried for the future of reading books?
No. And I don't understand a lot of the media because it's developing so fast and my eyesight is deteriorating. But I do remember a time in my life when my parents were very anti-radio. The wireless, they called it, because it was going to take away family conversations in the evenings.
Right.
And they were so opposed to the wireless going on. So we all get a little worried about what is new.
Each generation has their own worries, I suppose,
that's
don't
right.
they? But reading will always be around. I remember being under the covers at night with my light reading until 3 in the morning sometimes because I just loved it. And it was those early novels that when you're a young adult.
Yes.
Yeah. What is it that you most like reading about?
Well, now I can't read, but I've got talking books from the Blind Foundation. And I have asked if I can have non-fiction, because I've been writing fiction all my life and
right.
I just want a little bit of brain food.
You want to learn something now?
Yeah.
And I do. I learned a lot.
What exciting fiction you've been writing, mostly for children, but you did start off writing novels for young adults, but we were just talking
in the
break.
Well, I started writing novels for adults.
Yes.
My first novel, Nest in a Falling Tree, was made into a film by Roald Dahl.
Amazing.
He turned it into a murder mystery, but that doesn't matter. He paid quite a lot of money, which bought a lovely property in Marlborough Sounds.
Oh, that's good, isn't
so
it?
So that's what happened
See,
to that.
Reading and writing is profitable.
Yeah, it can be.
If you're as good as you, of course.
But here, now in Featherston, which is a little town with a huge heart, as are most Wairarapa towns you'll find, that being part of Booktown and a patron of Booktown is very close to me at my age.
What is Booktown? What is this festival?
Well, the festival was started 4 years ago And it has grown to the stage where last year we had 8,000 visitors coming to Featherston. It was wonderful. So, but there is something going on all the time. We've got probably about 3,000 people in Featherston, and we have 7 bookshops.
Wow.
7 bookshops.
That's unheard of.
I know it's unheard of.
And is it because of you?
No, it's not because of me. A group of people started it, and they made me patron, and I came into it. And I love being a part of that because it's binding a lot of things together that are important to me. People, the town, the surrounding areas, but above all, reading. And while ironically I can't now read myself, it's wonderful to see the reading, have a habit of reading going into school.
Do you still love the smell of a book?
Oh yes, oh, and the feel of
yes,
it.
Yes, aren't they fun?
But reading means a large magnifier from the Blind Foundation and holding it over and working out one word at a time.
Still writing though.
I'm still writing.
The Gobbledygook book.
Writing in 48-point print. That's all right.
It's fine. What is the book about?
Gobbledygook book is just a collection of funny stories and rhymes that children are enjoying. But adults apparently are enjoying them too.
Always.
Yeah.
And you don't do it anymore because of the eyesight, of course, but you used to love wood turning.
Oh, yes, I do wood turning. But these days I have to do it mainly by feel, and the finish is not great. I do simple things like bowls and boxes. I used to do more elaborate things, and I do it by feel, but I can't use the bandsaw that way.
Right, fair enough, and I don't want to feel the bandsaw. What a pleasure to talk to you, Joy Cowley. I hope that the Gobbledygook book is read by all the Kiwi kids.
And we will have another Booktown coming in May this year. Do come. You'll have such pleasure.
Shall we go?
Well, I'm coming. I'm doing 2 sessions at it. I'm hosting 2 sessions at it.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah, I absolutely love it.
Isn't it? It's exhilarating.
Magic. It's absolutely magic.
It's very hard to describe the extent of it and the influence it has.
I couldn't agree more. Yeah. Good. Go Featherston.
Thank you so much.